There's something undeniably addictive about a film with a great mystery at its core, and there are plenty of these movies just begging to be discovered. From psychological puzzles to harrowing whodunits to brooding procedurals, here are some great mystery movies on Netflix you should watch before they're gone. It took until 2007 before the right true crime mystery came David Fincher's way. Not surprisingly, the acclaimed director made the most of the moment, delivering what many consider one of the best that the genre has ever produced. The film in question is Fincher's immaculate thriller Zodiac, which details a years-long manhunt to find the man behind the brutal killing spree that terrified the San Francisco area throughout the late 60s and early 70s. Adapted from Robert Graysmith's book of the same name, Zodiac finds Jake Gyllenhaal portraying Graysmith himself as a whip-smart former cartoonist who slipped headlong into his own obsessive hunt for the taunting Zodiac killer.
Just because you can't prove it doesn't mean it's not true.
Fincher approaches that hunt with the same obsessive manner as the man driving the narrative. In doing so, he delivers a riveting first-person account of perhaps the most compelling true crime mystery in US history, if only because the Zodiac Killer has never been captured. He's featured prominently in two of the biggest trilogies in movie history, and even portrayed one of the MCU's original evil villains. But there was a time when Hugo Weaving was just a little-known actor trying to make his way in the Australian indie scene. And while common knowledge would say that Weaving's rise to prominence came when he suited up as Agent Smith in 1999's The Matrix, the truth is, it actually began with a wickedly duplicitous turn in 1998's Aussie thriller The Interview. There's a good chance you haven't even heard of The Interview. So let us tell you two things. It's a first-rate crime thriller fueled by a fascinating central mystery, and it features what may be the best performance of Hugo Weaving's career. We should also let you know that, like many of the great mystery films out there, The Interview's narrative takes the unreliable narrator approach, and the narrator here is Weaving's Edward Fleming, a seemingly poor soul who's fallen on hard times. The film is contained almost entirely inside an interrogation room, with Fleming playing the part of the wrongfully accused as a pair of forceful detectives present their case and try to wear him down. About halfway through The Interview, something happens that spins the entire narrative on its head. In turn, the film unravels into a daring cat-and-mouse game that's at as much common with the usual suspects as the work of Agatha Christie. Directed with a simmering menace and fractious energy by David Bruckner, 2017's The Ritual follows a disparate group of pals from college who, a year after a tragic death, come together to pay respects to their dearly departed friend. They do so by hitting the far reaches of the Swedish wilderness for a camping and hiking expedition. Needless to say, once the men enter the deep, dark woods of Sweden, they're plunged headfirst into a supernatural nightmare, the likes of which must be seen to be believed. Less a proper mystery movie than a film fueled by one unexpected moment after another, The Ritual fully revels in its unholy mysteries for much of its 94-minute runtime. When those mysteries are laid bare in the film's final act, well, nothing can fully prepare you for that unveiling, so we'll simply leave you to discover and enjoy it on your own. Over the course of the past 15 years, Mark and Jay Duplass have firmly established themselves as the no-budget kings of the Hollywood underground. They've done so by writing, directing, and starring in a string of audaciously original indie films, stretching across every genre. They've also dedicated themselves to giving up-and-coming filmmakers a crack at showbiz by producing micro-budget flicks that might be considered too fringe for the mainstream. Charlie McDowell's anti-rom-com fantasy The One I Love is among the best of those movies. Produced on a reported $100,000 budget, The One I Love finds troubled married couple Sophie and Ethan, played by Elizabeth Moss and Mark Duplass, struggling to save their relationship and deepen the throes of couples therapy. When their therapist recommends a weekend away at a secluded estate, the desperate duo jump at the chance to rekindle their romance. Upon arriving, Sophie and Ethan do seemingly begin to spark their emotional and physical connections, but it quickly becomes unclear whether or not they're actually connecting with each other. At the risk of giving too much away, we're gonna let our synopsis stop here, because the mystery driving McDowell's daringly evocative film is best explored with as little information as possible. Just know that the film categorically refuses to fit into any one narrative box, and it's as thought-provoking as it is bizarre.
God, it's so weird. It's so strange,
it's
isn't it?
It's really odd.
There's a lot to be said for a filmmaker taking the slow-burn approach on a mystery movie. In fact, the genre itself tends to encourage letting the unknown simmer, just long enough to bury into viewers' brains before letting the narrative boil over into whatever emotional hellscape the filmmaker is planning to unleash. And in terms of starkly slow-burning hellscapes, few have burned quite as destructively or burrowed quite as deep as Karen Kusama's propulsively somber study in Grief, The Invitation. Part bracing chamber drama and part tightly wound psychological thriller, The Invitation follows the story of Will, who's accepted an invitation for himself and his girlfriend Kira to attend a dinner party at the home of his ex-wife, Eden, and her new husband, David. With their old friends all joining the festivities, Will hopes the night won't be too awkward. While the party starts up on the right foot, an ominous energy begins to seep through every single moment, and it quickly becomes clear Eden and David have a very specific reason for getting the old gang back together. That reason is every bit as troubling as you might think. And yes, everyone on this party's guest list is in imminent danger.
There's something very strange going on here, and no one is saying anything.
As the tragedy unfolds, Kusama meticulously ratchets up the tension and guides the invitation toward a finale as genuinely shocking as it is utterly inescapable, with viewers left to wonder if anyone will make it out alive. In the Shadow of the Moon is a story of ambitious beat cop Thomas Lockhart and his charmingly unmotivated partner. In 1988, they happen upon a rash of wildly unusual deaths that tease the possibility of a serial killer. When that possibility is confirmed, the night takes a turn for the surreal. After being trapped by Lockhart in the subway, the fierce but youthful-looking killer reveals intimate details of Lockhart's life before she seemingly dies. 9 years later, Lockhart is made detective, and it's an utter shock when, on the anniversary of that fateful night, the killer resurfaces for a fresh wave of mayhem.
Nice to see you again.
The disturbing events that occur in the first part of this mysterious sci-fi thriller set the stage for a taut anti-procedural which spins the whodunit formula on its head. On top of all that, the film also introduces a classic science fiction plot device into the equation. In The Shadow of the Moon's disparate narrative tools prove vital to its fateful story, utilizing each to build an intricately orchestrated sci-fi house of cards that feels much bigger than it is. In doing so, the director delivers a cleverly observed puzzle box of a film, assembled with the eye of a detective to present a devastating view of the future. If there's one inherent truth about the mystery genre on the whole, it's that mood and atmosphere can make or break a movie. If you're a fan of writer-director Osgood Perkins' work, you already know that mood and atmosphere are his specialty. But just in case you haven't caught up with his 2016 haunted house thriller I Am the Pretty Thing That Lives in the House, you should know that it's all but consumed by both. Perkins' bone-chilling story is also a masterwork of minimalist horror. The burgeoning author indeed keeps this movie surprisingly compact. He uses just a single location and three central characters to sow the sinister seeds of a brooding psychological thriller, fueled by a finely spun fiction bleeding horrifically into real-world drama. That drama opens with Ruth Wilson's Lily taking a job as a live-in nurse to a famed horror novelist. The moment Lily moves into the house, unsettling events begin to occur that may or may not be tied to the macabre narrative of the writer's most famous book. As the story unfolds, it becomes increasingly unclear whether that book is fiction at all, and the answer may not bode well for anyone in the house. In exploring that possibility, Perkins crafts a bold, meticulously paced haunted house chiller with gothic energy to spare. We freely admit that we might be slightly bending the strictest definition of mystery movie with the inclusion of Netflix's full-throttle action film Wheelman on this list, because plots isn't really the point of the film. But if you'll bear with us, we think we can twist your opinion on Wheelman, because at the core of this film's taut narrative is, in fact, a marvelously constructed mystery. The story follows a skilled getaway driver who's fresh out of prison and back on the job purely as a means to pay off debts owed to local mobsters. One of his first gigs behind the wheel is a bank heist that doesn't go as planned. In the aftermath of the bank melee, the nameless driver has to ditch his accomplices and is stuck with a bag full of mob money, and no way to reach the man who put him on the job. To make matters worse, the driver is getting calls from a dangerous stranger demanding the money be delivered to him or his ex-wife and daughter will pay the price. Set almost entirely inside the confines of the man's car and told with a breathless sense of urgency, Wheelman's mysteries unfold with a steady hand, an insatiable appetite for anarchy, and an unapologetic tough guy acting ascetic.
I drive the car, I'm the Wheelman. Okay? That's it. End of story.
Along the way, Wheelman all but reinvents the action movie by framing its chaotic spirit with what's essentially an Agatha Christie-styled mystery. And yes, that's every bit as exciting as it sounds. Over the past decade, Norwegian author André Øvredal has proven himself to be a bold and brilliant filmmaker. After blowing the doors off the found footage genre with 2010's utterly superb Trollhunter, Øvredal returned for a journey deep into unsettling territory with his 2016 follow-up, The Autopsy of Jane Doe. While it doesn't innovate with quite as much zeal as Trollhunter, Jane Doe still finds Øvredal taking a daring new approach to well-worn genre tropes, this time in service of casting a manic web of menace over the mystery horror subset.
What's that for?
Make sure he's dead.
Øvredal expertly subverts every cliché he can conjure within the film's bracingly eerie narrative, which follows a father and son coroner team who set about to identify the body of a young woman and figure out how she was killed. Like the best horror mysteries, answers only raise more questions as the film ominously propels itself toward a shockingly sinister finale as thrilling as it is terrifying. The name Brad Anderson might not be instantly recognizable by general moviegoers. However, among the psychological thriller set, the talented director has more than earned their respect with several gems, including The Machinist with Christian Bale and The Call with Halle Berry. Drama cred aside, Anderson's brooding indie film Session 9 proves that his ongoing success is well-deserved. This relentlessly eerie movie is about an asbestos removal crew that's clearing out an abandoned psychiatric hospital. Equal parts psychological thriller and haunted house flick, Session 9 so effectively shrouds its narrative in mystery that some viewers might find themselves as lost in the story's exploration of soul-decaying trauma as the characters within the walls of the hospital. It's a harrowing experience, but well worth the journey. And when the film finally pulls the rug out from under you, it does so in a way that'll leave your head spinning for hours. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more Looper videos about movies on Netflix are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.